In this video, I'm going to go through the process of creating a panelized refrigerator. I'm going to change the materials, I'm going to apply the hardware, then I'm going to show you the process of creating an end panel refrigerator. And in a separate video, if you're curious of how I create the custom hardware for the refrigerator, you can search for that video and learn more about it. Let's go into the program and get started. In the plan that I have open, I'm going to begin by creating the panelized refrigerator. I'm going to show you the alcove and show you the process of creating the end panels when you have them exposed as compared to maybe an area that's not exposed and what the difference is. Let's slide over to the far side and let's begin by creating our panelized refrigerator. To create a panelized refrigerator, I use the full height cabinet. I'm going to go ahead and place one off to the side, and I'm going to go through the process of customizing this cabinet so that it turns out and looks like this cabinet off to the right. As you go through this process, you can find configurators such as Sub-Zero's reveal program that will go through and give you the dimensions and the separation values you need for the panels, and also the weight information and any other specs that you need to use. In this video, I'm going to make up a particular cabinet to meet the specifications of one of the refrigerators. To make the changes, I'm going to double click on this cabinet and open up the cabinet dialog. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to size the cabinet at 84 inches, the width at 42 inches, and the depth at 24 inches. For the molding on the panel, I'm just going to click and remove the molding off the top of it. And then on the face items, I'm going to go through by clicking on it, that will change my panel to the front, sides, and back. And I'm just going to step through the different elements of the face items. You'll notice in the completed version, we have a panel at the top that represents the ventilation, a single door with a style separator. I'm going to show you how to convert part of that to glass, and then two drawers. Let's begin at the top with a ventilation area. A blank area is going to recess that and won't be flush with the door. What I'm going to do is I'm going to set this top area to a drawer panel that will stand out and match and be flush with the door. I'm going to convert that blank area to a drawer panel, and I'm going to set the height of that at 5 inches. I like to press the tab key to get a preview update of it. The next component is the horizontal separation. I'm going to change that to a blank area, and all of these separations will be at a half inch. On the auto right door, I'm going to convert that to a full-size door. You'll find that setting down here with door right, and notice how it makes a very large hinge door. I'll change the style of that door outside of the dialog in just a minute. On the horizontal separation, blank area at a half inch. On the auto right door at the bottom, I'm going to convert that to a drawer. I'm going to split it horizontally. And on the top element, let's go ahead and set the height of that to 13.5 inches. Separation will become a blank area. Again, I'm using a half inch for all of these blank areas. On the final drawer, I'm going to set that at 14.25 inches, and then I'm going to go back up to the door area. And I want to set that and make sure that that's at 45 inches. Actually, 45.5 inches. On the horizontal separation at the bottom, I'm simply going to remove that. I have most of the components for the face items. On the toe kick, I'm going to change the depth of that. Let's go back on to the general panel. I'm going to change the depth of the toe kick to be 1 inch. Next, I want to change the door style as well as the hardware component. I'm going to open up the library. In the library, under Architectural, Cabinet Doors and Drawers, you'll see a preview of all the custom style of doors available in Chief Architect. I'm going to come down and find this double frame door and apply that to the cabinet. Then I'm going to change the hardware for the refrigerator. Let's collapse our library browser. I'm going to come down to the catalog that I've created specifically for this refrigerator. And I'll begin with the drawer hardware, and then we'll move up and place the door hardware. And if you'd like to learn more about the process of creating custom hardware, you can watch that in a separate custom cabinet hardware video. Next, I'm going to grab the material eyedropper, pick up the toe kick color off of the other refrigerator panel, and apply this onto the toe kick. Now I want to create an end panel for the refrigerator. If you have an exposed end, such as we do over here on the side of the door, you may want to have a panelized component. If you have an area that's not exposed, maybe it's adjacent to other cabinets, then you may have just a solid panel. It's recommended you use a partition for these solid panels. They're easy. They can have a molding, a crown molding at the top. And then for the side panel that has a panelized end, I like to use a full height cabinet and make customizations just like we did to the refrigerator. Let's go through and look at the two different techniques. Let's slide back around. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to use the partition to begin with. You'll find that underneath your cabinet tool, and you can click and place these partitions. Let's go ahead and change the size of it. It's going to be a little bit easier to double click on it, and then you can be very specific about the dimensions for your panel. I'll go ahead and set this to be 1.5 inches. And then I'll just simply slide that over, bump it to the cabinet, and you'll notice that I did not set the width of the cabinet. Let's go ahead and set the width of it, sorry, the depth of it to be 24 inches. And that's how you create the end panel. I didn't apply a crown molding to it, but that's an end panel, and these partitions don't have components to put face items on them. So what you're going to want to do in that case is use a full height cabinet, set it to 1.5 inches thick, and apply the face item. Let's do that off to the side of the cabinet over here. Let's rotate around. This might be a little bit easier to do from the plan view, so I'm going to slide back over to the plan view. And with the full height cabinet, I'm going to come over here, place it. I'm going to go ahead and rotate it. We'll bump it up against the refrigerator cabinet, and then I'm just going to go ahead and slide it to be 1.5 inches. You may have your cabinets bumping in 3-inch increments, and your minimum size might be set to be 9 inches. Remember, you can always double click, open up the cabinet, and you can set it to be any thickness you want. Let's go ahead and set this to be 102. The width of it, 24. The depth of it, at 1.5. Now you'll notice on the face items, they have hardware on there. You can click on these face items. There is an item type for your face item for a side panel that's applied or a side panel that's inset. I'm going to select this face item. I'm going to change it to the same inset. And then for the toe kick, let's go back to the general panel. I'm going to remove the toe kick depth, set that to be 0. And then you'll notice that my face items are not equalized. If I click back on here, I can go up to the top of the vertical layout. There is an equalize option. Now you'll notice that my panels don't have any profile to them. I find that easier to do in the 3D view rather than through the dialog. And then back over to the 3D view, I'll grab a cabinet door style out of the library, come over and replace that onto the panel, use the material eyedropper, paint it to be the same color. So you can easily apply these different styles out of the library, and I find that to be a little bit easier process. Now if you use the object eyedropper, we can pick up the crown molding off of this element. Let's use our scoping tool, make sure that we only have molding selected. I'm going to search for molding. And now I can apply that over to the partition. And then it's simply a matter of placing a wall cabinet in this area and filling that space. Now the next thing I want to do, if I turn on the camera to standard, notice that I put a glass front profile on that. I'm going to shoot an elevation view and I'll show you the process that I've done to create that. So from the floor plan view, let's go ahead and use the wall camera. You'll find underneath your elevation cameras. I'm just going to simply point and click through the wall. And in the wall elevation, if I toggle the camera back to standard, you can see the element that I have with the photo. Let's toggle that back to standard, so we can see a little bit crisper view. Now the way that I do this is I'll draw a polyline solid around the face item, set the thickness of it, go back to plan view, position exactly flush to the door, and then I'll go in and grab an image that I've captured that has the picture of the glass on it. Using the polyline solid tool, I'm just going to come in here and I'm going to draw a solid, I'm not going to be too exact for the purpose of the video, that will then sit on the front of the door. We zoom in a little bit, we can make sure that that's squared up. Usually I have my crosshairs on, but not for videos. And let's assume that that's close enough. I want to make sure that the thickness of this solid is very thin, because I don't want you to really see it, other than I want to use it to apply the image, because I can't just apply the image to the door itself. So I'm going to set the thickness of this by double-clicking on it, and I'm going to set the thickness of it to be 1/8 of an inch. Now I'm going to return to the plan view, and I'm going to zoom in, and I'm going to make sure that that is snapped flush to that panel of the refrigerator. I'm just going to slide that back until it snaps onto the front of the cabinet. Make sure that it's still exposed, so that way you can see it in your 3D view. From the 3D view, in the 3D view, you're not seeing that slab that we just drew from the polyline solid. My suspicion is we drew it and it's flush with the cabinet box and not the door panel itself. Let's go back to the floor plan view and turn that on. If I select the cabinet and I come down and I turn on the door style to be open, let's go ahead and turn it on. You can actually see the door style in the plan view right here. And I want to turn that so that it's 100% closed. So let's double click, open up the cabinet. And I want to take on this door area right here. And I'm going to change it so that it's 100% closed. So I'm going to change that to 0% open in the plan view and position that slab that we just drew and pull it out so that it's flush with that. So I'm just going to now slide that out so it's very close to the outside. So to be able to display your door panels and your drawer panels, you can do that. And if you want them flush like I have it right here, you'll have to set the percent open to 0. Let's go back to the 3D view. And now you can see that it's positioned accurately. I'm going to use the material eyedropper, pick up the material off of the existing glass, come over and apply it onto the slab. Now, if you're curious about how I've created that picture, here's what I've done. So I've found this image. And what I've done is saved it to my local computer, and then I added it to the library. Real quickly, I'll show you the steps that I did to create that. As I open up my library, I've stuck that in a folder. Let's go ahead and do New Material. I'm going to give it a name. And on the texture, which is actually the image, I'm going to browse out. You can see that I have an image in my folder. I'll go ahead and select that. I'm going to change the setting to stretch to fit, which is appropriate for a photo. And now I have that in my library. And then to apply it, you can click on it and come over and apply it to the object that I have. From the plan view, let's take a look at cleaning up the labels for the refrigerator and the end panel. Zoom in. And let's first take a look at the end panel that we created for the refrigerator. If you select the end panel, you can slide this label up so that it's very close to it. And if you double click on the end panel, you can come down to the label. You can specify the label that you want if you find a more appropriate label, whatever that may be. And then you can also click and suppress the panel or the label, and then it won't display. For the refrigerator, let's go ahead and select the full height cabinet we created for the refrigerator. Open it up by double clicking on it. On the label panel, I might come in here and type in panelized refrigerator. Or you could just type in refrigerator. The other thing you can do while you're in the cabinet dialog, on the general panel, you're going to find an option to include in schedule. This would show up on your cabinet schedule and it's more appropriate for a fixture and appliance schedule, clicking Include in Schedule, removing that check mark, will then prevent this from showing up in your cabinet schedule. Lastly, you may want to reuse this for future work. You can click on the object, you can click Add to Library. That will place a copy of it in your library, and then you can easily rename it and move it into the right folder. Now, if I want to block the image that we created on the front of the glass, you can come over, get out of the selection mode, select both the refrigerator, hold the shift key down, block both of those, add it to the library, and then you would have to give it a name, but then you can see in the preview panel it does have that glass image. If you then place it, unblock it, then you can modify it if you need to make changes. Maybe it's going to move to a 30-inch refrigerator. You can make any appropriate changes.